I wanted to decipher UK call signs. It's quite good fun, really, understanding how the whole UK call sign thing works. So if you are, you know, in another country, you go, oh, what are all these M's and G's and what do they all mean? But actually, it's also part of the syllabus for the foundation license. And that's why I'm doing it. I'm on page 19 here. Anyway, I'll put that away because I've got a better way of explaining this. Oops, a little bit more fun. And, let's just have a light-hearted video today, shall we? Make things a little bit easier. So, this is not a history lesson of all the G call signs and everything. Because there's people going to come on, try and correct me, go, well, it was 1982, not 83. All right. And these are the band police. All right. We don't care what year or anything else it was. And if I make a little mistake, it doesn't matter because the whole is greater than the detail. I just made that up. I don't know what I'm on about. Right. Okay. So let's just go back a bit. Certainly, more than 20 years ago, there was a number of different call signs issued in the UK. I'll just put my thing there. You can still see. But most of them started with a G. Okay? So, and there was two types of call signs. There was an HF, what they called a full call sign. Then we had a Class B, which is VHF only. So if you hear, in the main, you will hear G3, A, B, C, and you'll hear G4, A, B, C. That is the old school full license. The only difference between the VHF license and the HF is that these guys did 12 words per minute and scraped through an exam, and a lot of them promptly forgot it. Then they just carried on with SSB. So it's tragic at the time that the guys on VHF didn't get to use HF. However, because of that, the UK has a very strong, to this day, quite a strong VHF following and microwave and things like that. Okay, so, and about 20 years ago, the M series started. And initially, I think there was an M5 ABC. Not necessarily ABC, of course, going to be XYZ. The M5, I think, was a 5 words per minute test. And you can correct me in the comments if you wish to. Right, with that said, let's just go back to when I started just under 20 years ago, and we have three categories now of license. We have M3s, 6s and 7s. These are foundation licenses, and ideally, if nobody's watching, they're on 10 watts, right? They're not allowed to make their own equipment. They have to buy kind of type approved stuff, all right? Then we've got the two E0s, and by the way, I'm going to do region identifiers in a minute, just to make it more complicated. 2E0, that would be England, as this happens. 0 ABCs. These guys are 50 watts, and they've got a few more privileges. And then we've got the M0s, ABC, MCX, whatever else, which are the full, I used to call it advanced, I think. But there was a bit of a technical cock-up recently, and they also issued G2 ABs, I think G5 ABs, if you know what I mean, and a few others. Some of the old school brigade here went nuts because these guys were getting like a G2 Alpha Bravo, whatever else. And they just felt that was a really cool call sign, and they've had to suffer their three-letter suffix for 25 years. Why is it these people come on and don't? Whatever. It's called jealousy, in my opinion. Right. So, little history lesson. I'm now going to do regional identifiers. So, let's create one imaginary call sign. I haven't been on QRZ, so that might exist. It might not. And we will do... who are we going to do? It doesn't matter. I'll do me, all right? M0 MCX. That's my call sign. Now then, in simple terms, if I get my car and drive around the countryside, when I go into different regions, Wales, Scotland, Jersey, Guernsey, Isle of Man. I don't think I've left any out. I know it's the Middle Ages. Isle of Man, Northern Ireland. That's right. I knew there was one. Or Northern Ireland. I have to change my call sign by putting something in here. All right. And what do we put in there? So let's just draw a really bad map of the UK. And we'll put an island there. So we have Scotland. So if I went to Scotland, it would be Mike. So the regional identifier in Scotland, we'll put in red, is Mike. How do I remember that? Is that I'm Scottish and my name is McCormick. So clearly McCormick and Scotland go together. Then if we go to Northern Ireland, which is here, I'll become Mike India. So I become I, Mike India, zero, Mike Charlie X-ray. In England, it stays as it is. However, in Wales, which is to the left of me, because I live about there, in Wales, it will become whiskey, right? Mike Whiskey Zero, Mike Charlie X-ray. Now, there's three other little islands. One is the Isle of Man. I'll do these in red so you can see them. There's the Isle of Man. And then down here somewhere, we've got Jersey and Guernsey. Jersey and Guernsey. So the Isle of Man is Mike Delta. So that has, I'll keep it in red, that has Delta because the capital of the Isle of Man is Douglas. But also they've got a racetrack once a year, the Isle of Man TT. You might have heard of it, where they all go around on a motorbike. You could drive around that, right? You can drive around it, and that's how I remember it. D for drive, you can drive around the Isle of Man. Right. Then you've got Jersey and Guernsey. Now, Jersey is spelt Jersey, and Guernsey, Guernsey. So what they've done is for Jersey, they've put a J, so I become Mike Juliet. And then for Guernsey, I become Mike Uniform, because they've used the second letter, not a G. Otherwise, if I was G zero, GGG, I'd be GG zero, GGG. Be quite interesting, wouldn't it? Okay, so far so good. Right up to the point where they invented the 2E zero call. What's all this about then? I'll stick to blue. I think you can see blue all right. So we've got Mike identifier. Zero, Mike, Charlie, X-ray. And the identifier is here. Got it? Right. That tells us where the person is. There's no identifier. It means they're in England, effectively. However, the 2E series came along. There are other. There's 2E1s and all sorts of stuff. But let's just take the 2E0MCX. This is where we put the regional identifier. So you have 2 Whiskey Zero, Mike Charlie X-ray, 2 Mike Zero. I'll let you guess. They're all here. Mike, Delta, India, Whiskey, Juliet and Uniform. We can put them in here, you see. So far, so good. But in England, whereas we don't have a regional identifier here for England, we do here. We put in the Echo to England Zero MCX. There's a couple of optional things as well, and that I believe may be tested, is we're allowed to go portable. We're allowed to go alternative. I'll just write alt, and we're allowed to go mobile. So how you say that on the air is this Mike Whiskey Zero, Mike Charlie X-ray / mobile. Okay. The portable / P and / A. M, P and A are completely optional. You do not have to say them, and it may be tested, but because it's optional, it's probably not in the exam. Yeah. What will not be tested in this is that clubs also are allowed another regional identifier. And this is so esoterically baloney, even I don't fully understand it, but a club call sign. So I run a club call sign called Mike Zero X-ray Tango. All right. And as a club call sign, I'm allowed Mike X-ray. There we are. But can you imagine saying that? Mike X-ray Zero X-ray Tango. I think if I'm in Scotland, it becomes Mike Sierra Zero XXT. It's another identifier. God knows why. I've got no idea. If you know the rules for a club for all the other regional identifiers, put them in the comments. That'd be quite interesting. Okay, well, I mean, it's just a little tour of what all this means, because you might hear all these call signs, you might not have a bloody clue. You'll hear a lot of G's, you'll hear a lot of different M's. I think the only one we haven't used is a Mike 8. I once had a Mike 9 whiskey call sign as a contest call, so there was maybe a 9 knocking around. But Mike 1s have been released. I don't know about 2s and 3s. Mike 3s, yes. Mike 4s, I don't believe, have been released. Fives, that was the 5 words a minute. 6 foundation, 7 foundation, 8 and 9s in the main, they haven't been released. All the G's, I think, have gone. I don't know about a G9, G0. I don't know about a G9. If you know any obscure, full sets of call signs that have never been released, that'd be interesting to hear your comments in the comic. And that's how to kind of half unravel the UK call signs. It's a bit of a mystery, I know, because sometimes people go on about Australian call signs or US call signs and whether Whiskey 6, and I actually don't know what all of it means. I let N1M tell me when I type it in. Normally it seems to know. If this has been a bit of fun, give us a thumbs up, will you? And write a comment down if I've deserved it. All the best. Oh, sorry, next video is coming up here. I don't know what it is. I will let the algorithm determine for you. In the meantime, have a lovely day. Thanks for tuning in. Bye for now. Excellent.